Hello and welcome to the North Wall on Rathlin Island. This video is the first in a series where I'll be talking to you about a few different topics within marine biology. So this video is specifically about the North Wall. That is me, my name is Rebecca, and I've just finished my degree in marine biology. So I love biodiversity, and particularly looking at what species we find in what places. And you can see me there having a bit of a hunt on the wall. So the wall is actually just down from the Seabird Centre in Rathlin Island, so it's right next to quite a few of the bird colonies. It means whenever we're diving we can sometimes see some of them. So these are guillemots that you can see diving, and they're found in the cliffs around the dive site. So this is the wall itself. The top of it is quite flat and you can see some lovely red seaweed species there. And it then slopes down and it continues for about 200 metres. It can be different depths in different places. Now, the structures there are called dead man's fingers. You can get them in orange, you can get them in white. They look a little bit fluffy, and those are the individual polyps that are sticking out of the main structure. Have a look out for the different species you can spot. There's so many different ones to see. So we get soft corals, there are sponges, we get hydroids, which you can see there in those clumps. So it's like a stalk with a bit of a polyp on the top. They're cnidarians. And you can see some more sponges there. So lots of different species to see. And I'll be doing some videos later on to go into more detail. This just shows you an example that the whole wall region is made out of limestone. So these are actually divers' bubbles. So someone is under an archway at the minute and they're breathing. And because limestone is porous, the air bubbles can bubble through and you can see this lovely display. Okay, some more beautiful features here. So you can see more of those dead man's fingers, which are the soft corals. And there's another lovely sponge, and in it we have a velvet swimming crab. You can see its red eyes and almost like fluffy claws there. These sea anemones are colonial. So you generally find them in big patches that are a sort of orangey peachy colour, and the beautiful yellow sponge there is something we call a hedgehog sponge. You might see it pop up in a few of the videos. This is a brown crab. You can see these inshore sometimes, so this might not be new. And you can see more dead man's fingers, sponges. There's a few sea anemones there as well. And you can also see some clumps of hydroids, as well as some red seaweeds at the bottom. These are called Devonshire cup corals. You can also just call them cup corals for short. They're related to jellyfish, so they're cnidarians, and they almost look like they're glowing. They're that lovely luminous green colour, and you can see some little tentacles sticking out. You see a lot of those on the rock faces. This is a kelp forest. You can see the long, what looks like a stalk, it's called a stipe, and then the blades here of the kelp that we're going to move through. There we go. You usually find kelp in inshore regions, so just off the coast. Now this is a sponge with lots of species, but I'll challenge you to find as many different species as possible in this one screen if you hit pause. Okay, thank you for listening.